Hello and welcome back to Let's Play IL-2 Sturmovik with me, one of me, and we are not in our pilot career right now. Right now I'm flying the same plane as our career, the F-4F Wildcat, but I'm doing a quick mission here because I did a little bit of research and playing around and I wanted to let you guys know what I had discovered about the engine overheating problem. Right now, I can throttle around 80-90% without overheating, and the reason for that is because of the RPMs, which you can see there. Now, it's at 2.5-ish right now, 2,500 RPMs. 2,700, I believe, is the maximum that you should push it to for any sustained flight. But right now, I'm keeping my throttle at about 90%. It's all good, and we're not overheating. The reason for that is because of prop pitch, and I had a hard time understanding prop pitch. I know I explained it a little bit in my previous series, but I want to explain it again, partly for you and partly for me, so that I, you know, am held accountable for what I do and do not know. Prop pitch refers not to the physical pitch of the prop, but think of pitch as like a euphemism for frequency. Frequency as in RPM. So prop pitch is really the RPM of the plane. So I'm going to look at my RPM gauge here, and I'm going to reduce my prop pitch to 70%. You should almost never go below 70%. And you'll see my RPMs dropping there. It's almost down to 2 now, even though I've got it at 90% throttle. So if I throttle down to 80% throttle, the RPM gauge will shift even further. And our speed remains very close to what it was before, losing a little bit of altitude, so I can just trim that out real quick. But what I've been running it at is 100% prop pitch, and that's 100% RPM. You can see it skyrocket there. It goes almost to 3, and when I go all full throttle like this, like an idiot, it'll stay all the way up there, and then that'll raise my temperatures and not give me that much speed. I was going 340 before, and now I'm going 360. You only really want to do this when you're climbing or something like that. For level flight, you want to keep it, from my experience with playing around with this, it seems like 80% prop pitch and about 80-90% throttle will keep you from overheating and it will maintain a good speed. Now, altitude is another piece of that. At lower altitudes, you need less RPM because the air is thicker. So, your propeller bites into the air, and when the air is thicker, you need less rotations to bite. When you're higher up in the air, you want to increase your prop pitch because the air is thinner and you need more bite. Sorry about that. You need more bite. So right now I'm at about 80% throttle, I think. Something like that. Yeah, I'm 80% throttle and about 80% prop pitch, and I'm going almost 400 kilometers per hour, and my temperatures are quite normal. Now, if I wanted to go into a climb, this would not work. But if I want to go into a climb, I can throttle up, put my prop pitch up to full, and I will lose less airspeed and be more able to climb. So while climbing, you do want to keep it all the way gassed up, but you'll notice my radiator has been closed this whole time. You can open it up while climbing a little bit, probably to 4, and then when you get to the altitude you want, like I'm going to go for about 1,500 meters here, we're at 1,270, 1,260. You'll notice we're still staying above 300 kilometers per hour. After this, I'll go ahead and get back to the career, but I did want to show this off and share this with you guys, because it was something that I learned, and I don't know if I'm going to be able to apply it in a dogfight. Okay, so we're at 1,500 meters, and I'm going to go ahead and roll it down a little bit, reduce my prop pitch back down to 80, reduce my throttle down to about 90, so that we can have enough time to level out without dropping. And this is all without any flaps or anything like that. The engine never overheated. We gained quite a bit of altitude, and we're at the same speed that we went into that climb at. There's other elements to it as well. Right now, I'm going to increase my prop pitch to 100%. And if I throttle up like this, and if I dive at 100% rotation and 100% throttle, it'll actually slow me down than if I were to dive with a lower RPM. I don't know if I'm going to be able to demonstrate this properly, but we're going about 600 kilometers per hour there from 1,500 meters. Now let's see, we do want to keep it at what we have for this climb back up, so I'll see if I can get us back up to about 1500 to demonstrate that. But think of it as air resistance and increasing drag. If you reduce the rotations and bite, it will also reduce the drag in a dive. So, yeah, we are overheating as well. But we're back up to about 1600. I'm going to throttle down and reduce my prop pitch. My engine radiator right now is at 2. We'll turn it up to 8 and open it. And then that ought to cool the engine down, even though we're still going to be at 80% throttle, although I haven't tested this. This should work. It'd be good to know if this will work for cooling it off, because I do need to be able to cool off while maintaining, because I'm still, yeah, it cooled off already. Whoa, that was weird. And I'm still at about 300 kilometers per hour. I have no idea what is causing that, but, let me recalibrate that thing. Okay, so this time, I'm going to throttle down to 40%. And put my prop pitch down to 70. Like I said, I don't think you ever need... Or, okay, 60. I don't think you ever need your prop to go lower than that. Hopefully we'll have enough room to dive to the deck here. I don't think we will. That's actually about sea level. Already at 400. 500. Okay, so it seems pretty similar. I don't really know... Well, we didn't get to dive as far down. And then when you're climbing back up, increase the prop pitch and the power when you come out of it. But think of it like a, you know how to engine brake in your car? I don't know, maybe you do, maybe you don't. Think of it like engine braking when you're doing a high RPM dive. But anyway, that's what I've learned so far, and that should allow me to keep my plane in combat-ready altitude and speed without having the engine always constantly on the cusp of exploding. And since this isn't our career, we can go have a little bit of fun and see if I can end this with a bang. I don't like my propeller. Oops. I was going to pull up there, but... Anyway. let's go ahead and get back to the mission. Zzz, plural. Pilot career. We've been promoted to second lieutenant. And, well, I'll go back and... No, we can see the roster from here. We have 7 sorties and 4 overall kills, as well as a couple of ground kills. We've lost a lot of friends and companions, but for this mission we're going to be flying lead for Gunnery Sergeant Minner and following second to Johnson's group here. Now I may skip this if nothing happens. I'm probably just going to turn the camera off because this is just a B-17 escort, and it looks like it's an escort that's mostly in friendly territory. I will skip the approach, and then when we get there I'll turn it on and see if we get intercepted or if anything like that happens. But at the very least, this will be a testament to prop pitch, what I've learned, and how we're going to be using it from now on. I'm going to do my autopilot takeoff again, because I'm fucking lazy, and I don't like cranking them fucking gears up.
Hello, little friend. Good to see you guys.
So the B-17s are already in the air. And I don't see any enemy planes flying around already. So for once, for like a moment, they stopped attacking our airbase for like 5 seconds. It's remarkable. Alright, and then when we're back, we'll probably be somewhere near our attack point, which it looks like we kept point cruise, which is good because a lot of people died there. And we're heading for Tasimboko and Tiavu Point. We'll see you when we're there. Sounds like our guys are starting their attack runs somewhere.
Beginning our attack run.
And there they go.
Commence the attack. This is second flight. Roger, beginning our attack. This is six. Roger, beginning.
Sounds like there might be attacking some armor.
Beginning our attack. Attention, beginning our attack run. Armor, commence the attack.
Yeah.
This is two. Copy.
Can't really see what they're attacking now. I'm going to tilt it over, see if I can get a look at some of the impacts. Looks like they're headed for something over there.
10, altitude 10.
Oh. I had just taken it out of autopilot. Not my fault. Oh, there they go. Yeah.
This is 5, direct
Hey, they got him. Ooh, look at that. Brutal. Brutal. And we're getting fired on by something in that village there. We're just doing escort, though, so I don't really think it's my business to fiddle around with ground targets. Besides, it would put me out of position in the event that we were intercepted. Holy crap. Calm down. Calm down, bro. Anyway, you can see why I skipped the way here, and it looks like we're probably going to skip the way home. Because this is an uneventful mission. I may automate the takeoffs. I'm not automating the landings, though. So, for this, I'm going to put my prop pitch all the way up to 100%. Like I said, it will air brake us a little bit. Or not. I don't know how that works. Whatever, I'm just talking out of my butt. Regardless, we're going to lower our altitude and go in for an extremely fast landing. If my wings don't get torn off.
White leader, this is the tower. All right, you're clear for landing.
Let's turn on our landing lights.
Oh,
those are my cockpit lights.
On final approach.
There we go. That works as sort of like a headlight. You see, it sort of illuminates an area in front of your plane. We're coming in hot. But we were given permission to land. Turn my nav lights on too, so we're all blinky. Yeah, you can see it was illuminating the ground there. See it right there? It's illuminating the ground behind me though, so I'm not sure what purpose that could serve. I thought it was supposed to shine in front of me. Alrighty, from what I know, too, to add to the prop pitch thing, you want to keep your prop pitch at 100% for both takeoffs and landings. Just in case. Alrighty. Please don't hit my landing gear. Searchlight. A little bit faster than I would like, but not a bad little landing there. Ooh, I think I just took off again. Oh! I landed! Let's put up our wings so nobody can see us. Can they take away promotions in this game? Because they might. Me, I think that's impressive. You can't, not just everybody can do that, you know? That takes practice and skill. Safely landed again. Hooray. Let's go ahead and end that bullshit. Oh good, we weren't demoted. And it looks like we did do a decent job of destroying some of their armor. Hopefully that'll relieve some of the pressure. And it looks like we might have actually expanded our zone of control even more there. And maybe some more over here soon. So things are looking good. Let's see what the RNG has in store for us today. Another scramble. Looks like we're flying second. Yeah, we're going to be flying second in this wing. So our leader, his life is in my hands as his wingman. And I'm going to see if I can do some of this hatch maneuver stuff. As well as turning off autopilot for the most of the flight so that I can control my prop pitch and see if I can give myself a fighting chance at this. So we'll see you there.